Good morning, my dear students. Hope you are all fine. After introducing the three major sectors of economy in the previous lecture, today I will be discussing how we compare these three sectors of economy, how GDP plays a major role in dictating our economy, and finally, the historical change or shift in these three sectors. We will be discussing today. The first slide will discuss the comparison of these three important sectors of economy. So, comparison of the three sectors of economy. In an economy, there could be one or more sectors which are dominant in terms of total production and employment, while other sectors are relatively small in size. Thus, comparison of the three sectors of economy can be done on the basis of value of final goods and services produced. Economists suggest that the values of goods and services should be used rather than adding up to the actual numbers. For example, if 10,000 kgs of wheat is sold at rupees 8 per kg, the value of wheat will be rupees 80,000. The value of 5,000 coconuts at rupees 10 per piece will be rupees 50,000. Similarly, the value of goods and services in the three sectors are calculated and then added up. Not every good or service that is produced and sold needs to be counted. It makes sense only to include the final goods and services. For instance, a farmer who sells wheat to a flour mill for rupees 8 per kg, the mill grinds the wheat and sells the flour to a biscuit company for rupees 10 per kg. The biscuit company uses the flour and things such as sugar and oil to make 4 packets of biscuits. It sells biscuits in the market to the consumers for rupees 60. So, per packet is rupees 5. Biscuits are the final good, that is, goods that reach the consumers. Now let's move on to the next topic, that is GDP. So what exactly is gross domestic product? As you can see on your screen, the value of final goods and services produced in each sector during a particular year provides the total production of the sector of the year. The sum of production in the three sectors gives what is called gross domestic product of a country. It is the value of all final goods and services produced within a country during a particular year. GDP shows how big the economy is. In India, the mammoth task of measuring GDP is undertaken by a central government ministry. This ministry, with the help of various government departments of all the Indian states and union territories, collects information relating to total value, volume of goods and services and their prices, and then estimates the GDP. This flowchart that I have made here is just a brief explanation of how the value of goods and services in these three sectors are calculated and then added up. So now, moving forward. Now we will look into the historical change or shift in sectors. In the initial stages, the primary sector was the most important sector. Most of the people were employed in this agricultural sector. With the changes in the method of farming, the production increased tremendously. Now people could do other activities such as trading. They therefore became craftsperson and traders. Increase in production of grains and other things led to the growing need for transportation and other facilities. But in spite of this, at this stage, most of the goods produced were natural products from the primary sector, and most people were also employed in this sector. With the passage of time, machines were invented. Factories were established to manufacture various goods. Gradually, the industries were established and industrial sector employed more and more people. As a result of these changes, the secondary sector became more important in total production and employment. Thus, the importance of the sectors had changed. In the past 100 years, there has been a further shift from secondary to tertiary sector in developed countries. Tertiary sector is also called service sector because it provides basic services such as teachers, doctors, lawyers, internet cafe, and ATM booths. Tertiary sector became most important in terms of production. At present, tertiary sector employs the maximum number of people. So, there has been a shift from primary sector to secondary sector and then to tertiary sector or service sector in the developed countries. Now, student, this is perhaps one of the most important way of understanding how GDP is calculated. And through this very question, which is also mentioned in your NCERT book on page number 37, I will also try to explain the significant historical shift that has taken place through the decades. Here you can see the GDP of two different times. One is 1950 and the other is 2011. We will calculate the GDP of both these years and then individually evaluate the share or contribution of each sector in that particular year's GDP. First, we will start with 1950. As you can see, the final value of all these sectors have been added up to calculate the total GDP, which is 1,38,000. Now, with this calculation, we can individually analyze the share of each sector. As you can see, the share of primary sector, which is 57.97%, the share of secondary sector is 13.76%, and the share of tertiary sector is 28.26%. Now, we will repeat the same exact process with the year 2011 and calculate the GDP of all the three sectors and simultaneously evaluate the share of all three important sectors. We can see a major dip in primary sector's share, which is only 16.49%. A slight increase in the share of secondary sector, which is 26.12%, and a major accession or increase in the share of tertiary sector, which is 57.38%. Judging by the calculation we first did, it only proves that despite being recognized as a country which primary sector is incredibly important, the major shift in tertiary sector only suggests that India's economy is bound to rely more on the service sector. So, students, I hope you found this lecture informative and understandable. I'm also attaching an assignment in this video, which you can also find on your ERP. Please do check it, and if there are any doubts regarding this lecture, save it for the live doubt session. Till then, goodbye. Take